I'm not a doctor. I'm a logistician, and but what Doctors Without Borders learned very early, they were started in 1971, and they learned that you can put doctors in the field and that'll be great, but if they don't have medicines, what can they do? If they don't have fresh water for the populations, how long will anybody live anyway? So they realized that to really help populations, you had to have medical and logistical services at the same time. So that's why I'm not a doctor, but I work for Doctors Without Borders. So we've been driven from our homes, been walking, things are terrible, who knows what's happened to our family, and then maybe we finally get to a place where we at least feel we're safe. We don't have to keep running, okay? But what do we do? What do we need? We're going to stop here.
Just get a house.
We need a house. We need shelter. What else are we going to need?
Food
and water. Okay. So if you're lucky, maybe there's an aid agency here. Maybe there's Doctors Without Borders. Maybe there are others. There's lots of aid agencies. And maybe they have tents that they can give you. Or if not a tent, maybe they can just give you a piece of plastic, which is a lot of what we do. We just give out plastic sheets, and people can go out in the woods and find some poles and make a tent structure. Or maybe there's no tents, but you can go cut grass. And if you cut grass, you'll be able to build a little bit. We give out a package of stuff that we call non-food items. Okay, and every family is going to need a couple of blankets, a jug to carry water, maybe a couple of pots, a cup, a stove, maybe a mat, bars, soap. Okay, so we try to give out these. That was one thing that I did in Thailand. For every family, they would get a package. Okay, we are on a gorgeous sunny day on San Francisco Bay, but a real camp would look something like this. Like this one. This one over here, you know, you may be in the desert, and then 2 months a year, you know, as soon as it starts to rain, you get too much rain. So look at the mud. I was in South Sudan, and in no time, it's dry, 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 and then overnight it becomes a big, giant mud puddle like that. And look at this here. That's what a camp really looks like. You know, and people are cooking with wood and charcoal, so the air isn't very good, especially in the tents. And imagine the smells in a place like that.